The stories disintegrate you like waves.
Sia che il suo poema, il suo Elisaga, sarà messo o è già dentro un museo di Elisaga.
On Ellis Island, the stories howl through me like storms.
Certe cose non fanno una buona poesia. Le scrivi perché speri di aprire il tuo cuore sigillato dal lungo tempo. Questa nozione di essere sigillato da lungo tempo è centrale a questo poema, perché il poeta che parla, che ha avuto a che fare con me, un po' diverso, ma non tanto, per lui Ellis Island non è la porta d'oro, non è l'entrata alle libertà e le buone cose dell'America, invece è un tipo di carcere.
Certain things do not make for good poetry. You write them because you hope to open your heart, which you have closed too many times. People who hurt you for years now complain that you have hurt them. How do you decide what to do about these wounds? You have decided to expect nothing precisely, so that your own imperfections will not astonish you, nor will the imperfections of others drive you to fury. The music flows through the room where you are dancing. You have decided to feel something while no one is looking, or simply to allow the breeze to touch you. You have perfected a poetry of attitudes and remarks, totally useless at a picnic on the water. I was reading the story of stories they tell on the walls of Ellis Island. The stories disintegrate you like waves. They break you into a thousand, thousand faces, looking out at the skyline from the ships. Which of them do you become? You flutter across the stories like a wave. You are the change of shadow on the stories of stories and the soft backwash of tiny waves on the narrow beach. You are not a story, but an aspect of a story's story. And though you had expected a more substantial career, you appreciate the lightning swiftness of your influence. You are the eyes that transform the city, giving it the softness of Napoli.
La modificazione che più di tutto ha a che fare con l'eredità della grande migrazione, perché la gente si ricombina, si ricombina, si ricombina. You were from Barbados. You were from Jamaica. You were from the Caymans. You were from Puerto Rico. You were from Guyana. You were from Harlem. You were from Trinidad. You were from India. You were from Argentina. You were from France. You were from England. You were from Mexico. You were from Russia. You were from West Africa. You were from North Africa. You were from East Africa. You were from North Carolina. Your grandfather went to Utah. Your mother had a serious operation and died. The snow fell for 3 weeks without stopping in Toronto. The wind covered the bodies under drifts that froze solid. The mountains melted and the rivers filled, and you continued flowing in from the ocean.
On Ellis Island, the stories howl through me like storms. A noise with nothing to say except what meaning attaches itself to your skin in the touch of someone that loves you. Here we enter a vast space, neither sky nor sea. digging the subways, they brought dirt here in barges and made this well-positioned plot. We think of this as the Isle of Possibilities. We talk about the future as if we could touch it. We explore each other's faces as if we were concave mirrors. The trees here inhabit a perpetual hallucination. They think themselves to be sea creatures, monumental crustaceans evolved when the sea still filled with lava. We were facing the water and thinking 10,000 nights awaiting a single dawn.
Men drink Galliano made from 100 herbs, or Cinterma, which means 100 herbs, or Strega, which means a witch made from 100 herbs. These concoctions settle your stomach and change your dreams. They cut the water as if it were cloth, and you fall into memory. Old pieces of sunlight and branches of trees rush you as you sleep. A pyramid of logs and fronds goes up in the oven. The fire sucks air into the house and fills it with cypress. They are anointing the baby with olive oil and charcoal. For the moment, we ignore anything you can put in a sentence. A dream is its own kind of sentence. A memory is also a sentence. You wake up sniffing for smoke you recognize, but the air is empty. Each essence conveys its own entangled history. 100 times 100 times 100 makes a million.
Forum Romanum, entirely out of compressed paper. The formula for this astonishing feat they attributed to Giotto himself. But others now say some anonymous clever Goth in Borgo Santo Spirito did it. No one can tell this paper from the original marble. The travertine was all stolen to build castles for the families of priests. Building facsimile ancient Rome began in the 1300s. The history of Italy is the history of these clever initiatives. When studying Italy, always remember that priests control the banks. But mathematicians control the production of physical reality. They have redesigned every single horizon and mountain in Italy. Charming old cities illustrate esoteric Pythagorean ratios. The ancient Pantheon's dome uses fabricated stone in 20 weights. In the Himalayas and in the Andes, certain priests built mountains. No one can tell these from the ones that arise from bubbles below.
Italy inspires you to imagine things and then it defeats those things. The blue light of earth shines forth in no land more than in Italy. In river, sky, and sea, and rock, even the green has a blue cast. Steep towns arise like cocks on the roof who are part of the sky. The moment in which the world begins will take place in an hour. Fierce anticipation draws you outdoors to the world of the dead. Sputtering gray poisons into the piazza comes the dead Italian's truck. Lines of colorfully dressed dead parade in the market shadows. They organize restaurants so that every meal has a sacred theme. People pour blood of enemies into goblets before eating. The food itself exploits all the best ideas of 1 million years. Your new proposal amounts to what they used to do in the Seicento. Slabs of the future, like black ice, fall through the present moment. The dead with their chisels carve the fragments into human heads.
As if the only safe place was a cave. Disintegrate you like waves.